This program has been brought to you thanks to the generous contributions of our patrons on Patreon. Your patronage is greatly appreciated. And for more content like this, be sure to check out the Modern Alchemist channel on Patreon. Greetings, and welcome to Office Hours, the audio files. Today, we're going to be covering a question that was brought up during the Office Hours on September 12th, 2019. And let's begin. This question comes from Andy, and he writes and asks, "So, last night I was contemplating the pendulum swinging on a clock, and how that appeared to be a nice and easy way to think about polarity, rhythm, and vibration. But then I started thinking about the apex of the swing at the highest point on the far right and far left, and how the pendulum stops in midair for a mere fraction of a moment before changing direction. And I was thinking about how all of the momentum shifted right at that spot in order for it to start swinging the other direction. This line of thinking brought me to an aha. We've discussed previously the difference between the right-hand path and the left-hand path and how they flip between rest and action. And we've discussed the moment of atonement in which the Father becomes the Son and the Son becomes the Father. I've always had difficulty wrapping my head around that concept until I pondered the pendulum swinging. That brief fraction of a moment where the pendulum is at its peak and has a slight rest before swinging the other direction is the moment of atonement that we can actually observe. At least, that's the thought that kept me up most of the night last night. Are those observations on the right track? If so, can you help fill in any blanks?" Great question. Allow me to clarify a few terms and concepts. Atonement is the act of setting things right, putting things which were broken together and making them whole again. This is not a function of the pendulum swing. Perhaps a more productive way to consider the swing of the pendulum would be in line with the process of reincarnation and the natural flow of energy back and forth between the pillars. When it swings from the subjective right to the subjective left, the pendulum incarnates as an agent of severity within the domain of mercy. When the swing reverses, it reincarnates as an agent of mercy within the domain of severity. The top of the swing, when the pendulum is momentarily motionless, can be seen as the door between life and death, wherein the pendulum carries with it only the potential to become the agent in question. And literally, in physics, this is seen as the gathering of potential energy. Once in motion, the pendulum goes through the same rhythmic cycle all things enjoy: beginning, increasing power, middle or apex, the power at its height, and ending, decreasing power, until it reaches the height of the other side and contains no power and only potential power or potential energy again. You will note that this pattern precisely mirrors the pattern I have previously spoken about regarding the four stages of breathing: emptiness, filling up, being full, and emptying out. So your initial observation that meditating on the swing of the pendulum can be revelatory regarding the principles of polarity, rhythm, and vibration is absolutely correct. As for the pendulum relating to the Father becoming the Son and the Son, the Father, you can try to make that fit, but you may need a shoehorn to do it. However, were you to do so, I would remind you that the pendulum is always the pendulum, regardless of its swinging left or right. In this light, the Father would always be the Son and the Son always the Father, their actions mirroring one another. Sadly, I think that this comparison may only serve to confuse issues rather than solidify them into something more accessible. With regard to the Son-Father concept, another way to consider it is the reincarnation cycle of the male aspect as taught by Gerald Gardner and the Wheel of the Year and Wicca. There is no real end or beginning to this cycle. It also mirroring the four stages of breathing we discussed earlier. In this cycle, the Eternal Mother and the mortal father unite, and she becomes pregnant. The father passes on, leaving the mother, who then gives birth to her child, a son. The child grows, becomes a man, marries again with the Eternal Mother, and the cycle continues with the father incarnating as the son and the son becoming the father. Personally, I prefer the explanation provided by using the Tree of Life and observing the descent of Keter into Chokmah, father to son, and from Chokmah into Chesed and Tiferet, allowing the son Chokmah to become the father in Chesed and Tiferet. Good question, great thinking, and great observations. And this concludes today's Alchemy Office Hours, where we talked about the swing of the pendulum and atonement. I'll be talking to you soon.